What are you doing up here?
Just learning how to transport prisoners. I was going through the logbooks and all the rest, and I came across this Queensland Police Service Vehicle Operations Manual. And now learning some handy tips, if I ever need them.
All right, wrap it up. We've got other things to do, like putting our solar panels on.
I'm nearly done.
All right, let's go.
Welcome to today's video where we're tackling solar.
Yeah, so we're going to be installing 3 200-watt panels. We've gone with Renogy as the brand that we're using for the panels and for a lot of the solar stuff that we're putting in terms of inverters and charge controllers and things like that. Just from the research I've done, they seem to be a pretty good brand, and they're targeted at RVs and vans and motorhomes and things like that. So I've done the calcs on how much power we need in terms of battery sizing and then the solar as well. And I have done a video on that, so check that out if you haven't already. But yeah, essentially it's a combination of how much power you're going to use, making sure you've got the minimum panel sizing and batteries for your needs. But then obviously the more the merrier. I mean, in terms of budget and roof space, the more you can fit on is going to make your life a lot easier. So yeah, 3 times 200-watt panels is a fair bit. It just fits on the roof, and we've had to shuffle a few things around in terms of where our max fan went and a few vents and things.
Time to do some sketchy shit.
For mounting the panels, I'm using these brackets, which are actually Renogy, but you can get plenty of different types of those. I've seen people use like the little plastic corner squares that you basically stick a flex to the panel and to the roof. I'm a little bit hesitant to use something that just relies on a chemical bond for something that's holding a solar panel on the roof of your car. I've seen some, news articles of panels that have come off and hit cars behind, and it's not really something that I want to do. But yeah, at the moment, so basically you put those, they bolt to the panel and then they screw through the roof. So obviously you're trying to avoid putting as many holes in the roof as you can, but for me, I'd rather have a mechanical securing mechanism for the panels. They basically, yeah, bolt to the panel and then screw through the roof. And I'm just working out where these sit, because there are some pre-drilled holes in the panel frame, but just with where I want to sit it, I'm just marking out where this bracket's going to sit, and then I'm going to re-drill some holes. Just putting a bit of Loctite on this thread. Got that nut coming off. So I've just put the mounts on a bed of Sikaflex, the marine grade 291, and then I'm just going to fasten them down with the self-tapping screws that came with the mounts. I'm also going to put Sikaflex around the screws from the underside just to make sure that it's 100% watertight.
A little bit warm.
You got me the water so I can smooth out the Sikaflex? Perfect. Soap. That looks good, thank you.
What are you here for?
Thank you. Well, we got rained out yesterday, arvo. I think that's the best part of 5 build days we've had rained out on now. So we're back at it. It's a beautiful day. But yeah, that's one of the reasons we maxed out our solar and we also included gas. Panels went on pretty easily. Now there is a bit of logic to where I put them, and it all was dictated by where the shower is. So the shower is sort of under that area. I basically want to put a vent above the shower, so I didn't want a panel above that. The next thing I was considering was where the max fan was going as well. So the max fan I wanted to install on a flat section of roof. Once we had the shower position, this was basically the only last flat section we could use. So I put the max in and then the panels went around that. They've gone slightly off center there just to clear them away from where the awning is going to go. I've also just made sure when I put them in that the cable ends of the panels are all in the center so that it makes it easier to join them up. I actually think, considering how much surface area we have on the roof with panels and the air gap that's under it, it's probably going to help quite a bit with reducing the heat coming into the van by creating that air gap and protecting and shading the roof panels a bit. Now that the panels are installed, I've just got to get the cables down into the van. So for that, I'm using this entry gland, which is a Renogy gland, but there's heaps of different types of those. I'm going to sit this on the roof here. Our batteries and all our solar chargers and things like that are down below. I'm going to drill a couple of holes in there for the entry for the cables. And then I'm using these 4 to 8 mil nylon cable glands, which is those. Basically, they unscrew like this, screw that through, tighten it around the roof, and that's just going to protect the cable from that metal surface. And these are also IP68 waterproof as well, so it's going to give an extra level of water resistance if anything does manage to get in here. Doing a bit of cable management at the moment. So I've got a bit of this 25 mil flexible conduit, split this side of that just because I wanted to keep the connectors on there. And that's just gonna give it some weather protection on the roof. And then in terms of connection, I'm wiring these in series. So I'm just gonna connect my positive from this panel into the negative from that panel. And these are sort of universal MC4 connectors and they're wet waterproof. So you connect those up. I'm gonna run the negative, I was going to run that along underneath and down through that entry gland and down to the solar charge controller. And for that, I've got some 6 meter or 20 feet 10 gauge extension cords. These are Renogy ones, but yeah, just 10 gauge. They've got the MC4 connectors on those. So with the extension cord, it's got the MC4 connectors on both ends. There's a male and female. I'm going to be connecting that into the negative there, which I'll just leave unconnected for now. And then that end needs to go through the entry gland and down to the solar charger. For the solar charger, I won't need that MC4, and to fit it through the gland, this won't fit, so I'm just going to cut that off. That's not connected. Even though I've connected that, I haven't actually connected up all the panels, so there's no live circuit at the moment. So after much more effort than anticipated, I've got this cable, which is the positive from this panel, under and over that rib, and then under and then out of here. Piece of advice, if you do want to lay your cables a specific way under the panels, maybe put them down before you screw the panels down and then have a nightmare of a time trying to get them under. But yeah, that's the positive from there. So these are wired up, so that's positive to negative in this panel. The negative goes through to that gland. The positive from this panel comes through and under. That's the positive. The positive will go into the negative of this panel. I'm just gonna leave those apart so I don't create a live circuit with 60 something volts in it. And then this is the positive from this panel here. This is gonna go into my other extension cord. So that's going to go into there, and then I'll cut the end off this one. Bye. That's going to go on an adventure. And then these are the two cables that are then going down and into the van through the gland. So I guess we can put that in now. So Brooke's just going down inside and she's going to push the glands up through the hole. I think technically this is the wrong way, but I just wanted a bit more clearance inside this entry gland. So I'm just using marine grade sicker to secure this entry gland.
go get some lunch.
Chili con carne.
Chili con carne.
The roof's a bit dirty, but that's the finished product there, other than those two cables that are unplugged. So when we're ready to wire that in, we will connect those up and they'll get tucked under and tied under the solar panel. Solar panels are all installed, which is pretty exciting because that's one of the last big things we have to do outside. So as you can see here, cables are coming in and we've just got them bundled up, ready for when we do the solar system install, I guess. So we'll do a video on that when we get to it, and that'll be wiring up all our charge controllers, the inverter, all that sort of thing. So yeah, I think that'll probably be a little while away, but yeah, for now, I've got all that sorted. I did connect it up quickly and chuck the multimeter on it, and we're getting like 70 something volts coming in, so all looks to be working. But now I've disconnected it again on the roof, so we don't have a complete circuit, because that's getting up there in some voltage that could be dangerous. So yeah, no complete circuit at the moment, but yeah, just left that like that, and when we get round to doing the solar, we'll do a video on that. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, chuck them down below and we'll do our best to get to them. Sounds like we're a big
Deb, the one comment from Deb, though. Oh, we'll see if we can get around to it. Sorry.
What you doing in there?
Is that a leech on the back?
He's got a big leech on him.
Oh, no, is it?